expensive shops in the famous Acadian Cemetery. We are just opening at this time of the morning. The arcade was almost empty. Mr. Dillon, the owner of a jewelry shop, was unwinding a new window display. Two of his assistants have been working busily since 8 o'clock and have only just finished. Diamond necklace and rings have been beautifully arranged on a background of black velvet. After glancing at the display for 7 minutes, Mr. Taylor went back into his shop. The silence was suddenly broken when a large car, with its headlights on and its horn blaring, roared down the arcade. It came to a shop outside the jailers. One man stayed at the roof while two others, with bad stocking over their face, jumped out and slammed the window of the shop with iron bar. While this was going on, Mr. Taylor was upstairs. He and his staff began throwing furniture out of the window. Chairs and tables went flying into again. One of the face was struck by a heavy stain, but he was too busy helping himself to diamond to notice any pain. The wave was all over in 3 minutes, for the man swept back into the car and is put off at a fantastic speed just as it was leaving. Mr. Taylor rushed out and one after each rolling and chased at west, but it was impossible to stop the fist. They had got away with thousands of pounds worth of diamonds. Have it ever happened to you? Have you ever put your trousers in the washing machine and then remember that there was a larger bank note in your back pocket? When you rescued your trousers, did you find the note was wider than why people who live in Britain didn't know? That's when they make mistakes like this, and a lot of people too. Fortunately for them, the Bank of England has a team called the Millet Ladies, which deals with claims from people who feed their money to a machine or to their dog. Dogs, it seems, love to scrape up money. Our recent case concerns Jane Britain, whose finance John runs a successful furniture business. John have a very good day and put his wallet containing £3,000 into the microwave oven for safekeeping. Then he and Jane went horse riding. When they got home, Jane cooked their dinner in the microwave oven and without realizing it, cooked her finance wallet as well. Image their dismay when they found a beautifully cooked wallet and turned to ash. John went to see his bank manager, who sent the remains of wallet and the money to the special department of the Bank of England in Newcastle. The ladies, they examined the remains and John got all his money back. So long as there is something to identify, we will give people their money back, said a spokeswoman for the bank. Last year we paid £1.5 million or 21,000 grams damaged bank. The Queen's head appears on English bank, and ladies refer to this decrease St. Bernard Pass gone as Switzerland to Italy at 2,475 meters. It is the highest mountain pass in Europe. The famous monastery of St. Bernard, which was founded in the 11th century, lies about a mile away. For hundreds of years, St. Bernard dogs have saved the lives of travelers crossing the dangerous path. This friendly dog, which we have first bought from Asia, we have used it as much dog even in Roman times. Now that the tunnel has been built through the mountains, the path is less dangerous. But each year the dogs are still sent out into so whenever a traveler is in difficulty. Despite the new tunnel, there are still a few people who wisely attempt to cross the path on foot. During the summer months, the monastery is very busy. For ages visited by thousands of people who cross the path in cars, as there are so many people about, the dogs have to be kept in a special enclosure in winter. However, the temperature dropped to -30 degrees and very few people attempt to cross the pass. The months before we return to summer, but they have more privacy. The dogs have greater freedom too, for they are allowed to wander outside their enclosure. The only regular visitors to the monastery in winter are parties of skiers who go there at Christmas and Easter. These young people who love the peace of the mountain always receive a warm welcome at St. Bernard Monastery. Guests never fail to fascinate human beings. They can be friendly and affectionate towards humans, but they lead mystery lives of their own as well. They never become submissive like dogs and horses. As a result, humans have learned to respect